We're traveling by bike for 1 year, and we start in the Arctic Circle in Norway. Once we get going, the nature blows our minds.
So beautiful!
But we also end up being very wet and very cold. It's too much. So in pursuit of less terrible weather, we ride to Narvik, where we can take a train to Sweden. This 550-kilometer train ride across the terrain of the Arctic landscape. It's a sight to behold.
The beauty of this nature has really been the DNA of our journey so far.
As we slowly depart from this place we have come to love, we say a silent goodbye and ask ourselves,
what now? What will define our time in Sweden?
Is there any way the void left by maybe the most beautiful country in the world can be filled? Here in Luleå, we're south of the Arctic Circle. And while the sun still never really sets, we can, for the first time in weeks, enjoy hints of what a sunset looks like.
We had a great first warm shower stay back at Rona's place. And now we found one more, right here in Luleå. They live pretty close by, and it will take some hours before they're home. So while we eat lunch here in the outskirts of Luleå, let's talk about.
Right now, we're in central Sweden by the Gulf of Botnia. Our goal of reaching Ushuaia in the south of Argentina by the end of the year remains the same. But
instead of riding through Western Europe to Madrid, we're gonna go south from Luleå to Umeå, take the ferry to Finland,
continue down through the Baltic countries and Eastern Europe all the way down to Istanbul.
In Istanbul, we can get a direct flight to Buenos Aires and connect with our original route.
When we started to map out this new plan back in Steinfjord,
it made us realize this is not just a plan to escape the rain. It's a way to make better use of this 1 year freedom we have given ourselves.
A way to visit a bunch of countries we haven't been to before and make the adventure even bigger.
Let's meet our hosts. This is Göran. Göran, who happens to be a very talented professional musician, lives with her husband Patrick and their two boys Tor and Eva in this beautiful house by the lake.
They are experienced bike travelers. The whole family have been on multiple trips all over Europe on this incredible quad tandem bike. We spent the evening sharing stories from the road and talking about life in general. Later, they take us out on the lake to try out their amazing floating sauna.
Just wow, this is so cool. Family goals.
The adjustment is working. Sure, this morning is overcast and gray, and it might even rain later, but it's easily 10 degrees warmer here than it was in Norway. There are no hosts on warm showers in the general direction we are going today. But full of faith in humanity, we sign up for couchsurfing. And on Couchsurfing, we find Mikael in Piteå.
He thinks it's very cool we wanted to come to Piteå, and he is happy to host us.
The ride to Piteå is great. We're surrounded by dense forest and we're almost alone. We see like three people the whole way. We arrive in the middle of a street party. And when we walk up to the house,
they play this song.
It's the World Cup anthem for the 1986 national Danish football team.
Right away, Mikael asks us if we want to stay an extra night because they have gatherings for the whole weekend planned.
Yeah.
And of course, we gladly accept.
We end up spending the entire weekend eating great food,
drinking wine and beer, and trying to prata så mycket svenska as we possibly can.
We play games in the garden and meet interesting people, including a bunch of musicians.
I'm Justina, an Iranian singer, songwriter and rapper. I was arrested in Iran because of singing.
And the reason she was arrested for singing is because she's a woman.
There are many peoples in the world that they never have the freedom that you have. I think it's important to know them and feel them and be careful about our freedom. You can lose it easily.
Justina's message resonates deeply with both of us.
It's a stark reminder that having the freedom to travel the world like we're doing right now is not something we should take for granted.
The freedom that you have is because of the people lived in past, and you should keep it for rest of your life and next generation.
We are truly happy for Justina that she's here in Sweden, surrounded by good people. She's able to sing and rap.
Also at the party is
Augusta. She's a local, talented indie pop singer-songwriter.
And she is kind enough to take a request and play one of the best songs ever.
Well, you've got your diamonds and you got your pretty clothes, and the chauffeur drives your car. You let everybody know, but don't play with me, 'cause you're playing with fire. Your mother, she's in Arizona's a block in St. John's Wood. And your father be there with her if he only could. But don't play with me, 'cause you're playing with fire. Your old man took her diamonds and tiaras by the score. Now she gets a kicks in Stepney, not in Knightsbridge anymore. So don't play with me, 'cause you're playing with fire.
Take care. Bye.
Now you've got some diamonds and you will have some others. But you better watch your step, girl. Start living with your mother. But don't play with me, 'cause you're playing with fire. So don't play with me, you're playing with fire.
We spent 2 days riding 169 kilometers to this wonderful house in the middle of nowhere. And it seems we have finally caught up with the summer again.
Det er varmt nok til at skulle ud og bade udenfor. This outdoor shower is an instant life memory.
I don't know why, but this place conjures up a lot of emotion. We both feel different. Being alone out here is giving us room to reflect on our time in Sweden so far, and all these people we have met. The way they just open up and invite us in.
We are full of life, energy and love, and irrationally happy. The last 5 days have been beautiful.
In more ways than we could have ever imagined.
To our people in the past who fought for our freedom. Cheers.
Yeah, why bikepacking? Why bike traveling?
The Swedish people are really, really nice.
We have 110 kilometers tomorrow.
If you like our videos and want to see more episodes about this amazing 1 year bike journey around the world, then please support the channel by subscribing and by sharing all our videos with all your friends and all your family. Thank you for watching. See you in episode 5.